Hello grade 8 students. How are you today? This is your teacher, Ma'am Raina. Today, we are going to learn about South Central and West Asian arts. Our most essential learning competencies are analyzes elements and principles of art in the production of arts and crafts inspired by the cultures of South Asia, West Asia, and Central Asia. Identifies characteristics of arts and crafts in specific countries in South, West, and Central Asia. India, Rangoli, Kathak, Mehndi, and Diwali, Saudi Arabia, carpet design. Pakistan, truck art, and Tibet, mandala. Lesson 1. Periods of Indian art. There are four periods of Indian art. The first one is the ancient period, 3900 BCE to 1200 CE. Evidences of early civilization. Bronze and copper statuettes, steatite seals. Ajanta caves of Maharashtra, India. 30 rock-cut cave monument that date back from the 2nd century BCE to the 600 CE, including paintings and sculptures considered to be masterpieces of Buddhist religious art, as well as frescoes that are reminiscent of the Sigiriya paintings in Sri Lanka. Next is the classical period, 5th to 6th century. Shiva the Destroyer develops into Shiva the Cosmic Dancer, represented by a four-armed figure. Shiva, his one hand holds the fire with which he destroys, another holds a drum, which is the first sound heard in the world during creation, the third arm points up, in a reassuring gesture, and the fourth arm points down, to the dwarf in which he dances to. Next is the Islamic Ascendancy, 1192 to 1757. This was the period of evolution from Vedism into Hinduism or Brahmanism. The two great Indian epics, the Mahabharata and the Ramayana, emerged in this period. And last is the Mughal period, 16th century. Mughals contributed to the enrichment of Indian culture, in painting and in architecture. The most splendid sample is the Taj Mahal, built in 1632 by Shah Jahan in memory of his wife. Lesson 2. Folk arts of India. Diwali. Diwali is celebrated by Hindus in India and all around the world in October or November. It is the Hindu New Year and is either a 3-day or 5-day holiday, depending on where you come from. It is a very exciting and colorful holiday, where homes are cleaned to welcome the new year, and windows are opened, so that the Hindu goddess of wealth, Lakshmi, can enter. Hindus believe that she cannot enter the house which is not lit up, so every household burns special Diwali clay lamps, diyas, to light the way of the goddess. This is why the holiday is also known as the Festival of Lights. Rangoli. It is one of the most beautiful and most pleasing art forms of India. Rangoli came from the words, rang, which means, color, and avali, meaning, colored creepers, or, row of colors. Rangoli is the art of making designs or patterns on the walls, or the floor of the house, uses finely ground white powder, along with different colors. Numerous households in the Indian subcontinent make use of rangoli designs for decorating the courtyard of their houses. The traditional form of rangoli made use of designs and motifs based on nature, such as mangoes, creepers, flowers, swans, peacocks, etc. Mehndi. It is a form of body art and temporary skin decoration, also refers to the marriage feast on the occasion of the bride's hand and feet being stained with henna. Each motif, it is believed to bring hope, joy, love and keep the bad spirits away. Most people believe that the longer the henna pattern lasts, the life care the person wearing it will be. The base of the design is a circle, square or rectangular element. From the central element, the artists work out surrounding designs and patterns. Kathak. Kathak is one of the main forms of classical dance drama of India. It emphasizes rhythmic foot movements with small bells, and the movement harmonized to the music. Lesson 3. Pakistan. Around the middle of the 3rd millennium BCE, an advanced urban culture developed for the first time in the region. Large buildings were built, some of which still survive today, like Mohenjo-Daro, Harappa, and Kot Digi, which are among the pre-Islamic settlements that are now tourists' attractions. Pakistani truck art. Across Pakistan, brightly colored flamboyant trucks, painted with images of idealized landscapes, famous personalities, flowers and trees, turned village lanes, city streets and long-distance highways into a gallery without walls. A free-form kaleidoscopic exhibition in motion. Many trucks and buses are highly customized, and decorated by their owners. The decoration often contains elements that remind the truck drivers of home, The art is a mode of expression for the truck drivers. Decoration may include structural changes, paintings, calligraphy and ornamental decor like mirrorwork on the front and back of vehicles and wooden carvings on the truck doors. Depictions of various historical scenes and poetic verses are also common. Lesson 4. Saudi Arabia. Throughout the Arabian world, you can find an abundance of both kilims, or flat weave carpets, and pile carpets. You can find different knots used as well. The artistic boundaries of carpet production techniques and design are not bound by the rigid lines that separate our modern nations. Arabian rugs. Arabian carpets are primarily made from wool, but one finds a broader variety of materials in the area as compared to other regions of the world. Cotton and flax are easily grown in the northern portion of Egypt. You can find carpet that use both cotton and linen threads. You can also find rugs made from camel hair and goat hair in some areas. Sometimes, silk is used too. Lesson 5. Tibet. Mandala of Tibet. A mandala is a spiritual and ritual symbol in Asian cultures. It can be understood in two different ways. Externally, as a visual representation of the universe, or internally, as a guide for several practices that take place in many Asian traditions, including meditation. In Hinduism and Buddhism, the belief is that by entering the mandala and proceeding towards its center, you are guided through the cosmic process of transforming the universe from one of suffering into one of joy and happiness. In their most basic form, mandalas are circles contained within a square and arranged into sections that are all organized around a single, central point. They're typically produced on paper or cloth, drawn on a surface with threads, fashioned in bronze, or built in stone. While extraordinary as a standalone work of art, mandalas hold symbolic and meditative meaning beyond their vibrant appearance. Now let's try to answer this activity. Great job! Impressive! You did well! That's all for today, class. I hope you learned something about South, Central, and West Asian arts. See you again on our next episode. Goodbye!